Hello my dear children, welcome back to our English class. Today we are going to deep a lesson from class 10th. The title of the lesson is Every Success Story is Also a Story of Great Failures. Before we go into the lesson, let us discuss about the author. The author of this lesson is Shivakera. Shivakera is an Indian author of self-help books and activist. While working in the United States, he was inspired by a lecture delivered by Norman Vincent Peale and followed his motivational teachings. Kera has written several books including You Can Win. His mission is to ensure freedom through education and justice. Shivakera was born in a business family which used to have a coal mines at Kendua in Dhanbad, India. Soon after the nationalization of coal mines by the Indian government, he had to search for his own living. In his early years, he worked as a car washer, a life insurance agent, and a franchise operator before he became a motivational speaker. Now let us discuss about the lesson, Every Success Story is Also a Story of Great Failures. The title itself is very interesting, right, children? Yes. When we hear or see about the famous personalities or celebrities, we might think they are born with silver spoon. As a coin has both sides, they too face many difficulties in their lives to come to such positions. Come, let's know about few famous people who we know but how they have reached such heights. Okay? So, failure is a highway to success. What's the meaning of failure? Failure means lack of success. Okay? Failure is a highway to success. Tom Watson Sr. said, if you want to succeed, double your failure rate. I request you all to underline this sentence. If you want to succeed, double your failure rate. What does it mean? It doesn't mean that you have to fail wantedly. Okay, it doesn't mean that you have to wait, you have to fail wantedly. If you want to succeed, you have to make new attempts. If you want to succeed in your life, you have to make new attempts so that what happens, you will fail faster, right? And if you fail faster, what happens? You will learn faster. And if you learn faster, you will grow faster. So this is the meaning of this sentence. If you want to succeed, double your failure rate. It means that you have to make numerous attempts, and if you fail numerous times, you will learn faster and you will grow faster. Okay. So who is Tom Watson Sr.? He is an American businessman. Okay. He is an American businessman and he is the CEO of IBM. Okay, Tom Watson Sr. is an American businessman and he is the CEO of IBM. Okay, children, now let us move to the next paragraph. If you study history, you will find that all stories of success are also stories of great failures. Yes, Shivakera quoted few examples in the given lesson. He compiled few essays. Okay, so when we go through their life history, we only see the success of them. We only know the success of them, how they have succeeded. But only one side of the coin we know, only one side of them we know. Whereas in their life, they too have faced many difficulties to come to that position. Okay, but people don't see the failures. They only see one side of the picture and they say that person got lucky. Yes, we all feel that he is very lucky. That's why he or she is in that position. He must have been at the right place at the right time. We always think that he got very lucky and he is at the right place at the right time. Okay, now let us go through few examples here. Okay, first one, we all know him, right? Who is he in the given picture? All of you look at the picture. Do you know him? Yes. He is Abraham Lincoln, right? We all know that he is the president of United States of America, right? We all know that he is the president of United States of America. Now let us see his life history once. Okay, let us go to the paragraph. Let me share someone's life history with you. This was a man who failed in business at age 21, was defeated in the legislative race at age 22, failed again in the business at age 24, overcame the death of his sweetheart at age 26, had a nervous breakdown at age 27, lost a congressional race at age 34, lost a senatorial race at age 45, failed in an effort to become vice president at age 47, lost a senatorial race at age 49, and was elected president of the United States at age 52. This man was Abraham Lincoln. Would you call him a failure? He could have quit, but to Lincoln, defeat was a detour and not a dead end. See, let us go through the paragraph in detail. So this man, Abraham Lincoln, failed in the business at the age of 21. He started his business at the age 21. And he was defeated in legislative race at age 22. Again, he failed in the business at age 24. And he overcame the death of his sweetheart. Who is the sweetheart here? She is his love. So he overcame the death of his sweetheart at age 26. Had a nervous breakdown. What is the meaning of nervous breakdown? It means that he gone through a mental depression. Why he went through a mental depression? Because he lost his girlfriend, and that's why he gone through a mental depression. That is a nervous breakdown at age 27. And again he lost a congressional race at age 34. He lost a senatorial race at age 45. And again he made an attempt to become the vice president, but he failed. Again he lost a senatorial race at age 49. And was elected as the president of United States at the age of 52. Actually, the age 52. See, it most of them like to take rest during this time, right? So here, it was not an easy thing for him to reach such great height in his life, right? He faced major setbacks in business as well as politics before he was elected as a president of the United States at the age of 52. He didn't lose hope, right? He did not lose hope, and he did not give up his efforts. And this man was called as Abraham Lincoln. Do we call him as a failure? No, because he changed the failure into an alternate route, and it is not the dead end. See, would you call him a failure? No, right? He is not a failure because he made numerous attempts. At last, he became the president of United States at the age of 52. He could have quit. See, he made numerous attempts, but he did not quit. But to Lincoln, defeat was a detour. What is the meaning of detour? It was only a sideline, or it is an alternate route. This is all about Abraham Lincoln. Okay, now let us go through one more example. That is about Lee D. Forrest. In 1913, Lee D. Forrest, the inventor of the triode tube, was charged by the district attorney for using fraudulent means to mislead the public into buying stocks of his company by claiming that he could transmit the human voice across the Atlantic. He was publicly humiliated. Can you imagine
where we would be without his invention? Okay, so this Leary Forrest, he is one of the fathers of electronic age. Okay, so he is an American inventor. He is an American inventor who invented Triode's tube in the year 1913. He invented Triode's tube in the year 1913, and this man was also charged by the district attorney. District attorney means the lawyer. Attorney means lawyer. What did he charge? That he was charged by saying that he was cheating the public, or he was cheating the people by saying that he could transmit the human voice across Atlantic. He was publicly humiliated. Humiliated means he was insulted publicly. Why he was humiliated? Because he said that he could transmit the human voice across Atlantic. Okay, so just imagine now, we cannot imagine ourselves or our technological development without his invention, right? So we cannot really imagine without this Triode's tube, right? Without this Triode's tube, we cannot amplify or we cannot produce the sound. Even though he was also publicly humiliated, that he was misguiding the people, that he was misguiding the people and asking the people to buy his stocks. What is the meaning of stock here? It means that it is a share that somebody buys in a company. Okay, this is about Leary Forrest. It is also a failure for him. In spite of all those humiliation and all, he became successful in his life. Let us discuss one more example about the Wright brothers. A New York Times editorial on December 10, 1903 questioned the wisdom of the Wright brothers, who were trying to invent a machine heavier than air that would fly 1 week later. 1 week later, at Kitty Hawk, the Wright brothers took their famous flight. Okay, so what is a New York Times here? It is a daily newspaper. What is the New York Times? It is a daily newspaper that is published from New York in America. Okay, what is the meaning of editorial? What is the meaning of editorial? Editorial means it is an article written by the editor of the newspaper expressing an opinion on something. Okay, so what was the question raised by New York Times? What was the question raised here? The question raised by them was, how can anyone invent a machine heavier than air that could fly? Okay, so according to the knowledge of the people in those days, anything that is heavier than air couldn't fly. Okay, so here the article ridiculed. Ridiculed means it made fun. It made fun of Wright brothers. Okay, so by proving all this wrong, 1 week later at a place called Kitty Hawk, Wright brothers took their famous flight. Okay, so the Wright brothers successfully took their flight after their wisdom was questioned by the New York Times editorial. This was really a great success for Wright brothers. Let us discuss one more example, that is about Colonel Sanders. See, this Colonel Sanders, he was the founder of KFC chain restaurants. We all are very much fond of KFC chicken, right? Kentucky Fried Chicken. Okay, let us go to the paragraph now. Colonel Sanders, at age 65, with a beat up car and $100 check from Social Security, realized he had to do something. He remembered his mother's recipe and went out selling. How many doors did he have to knock on before he got his first order? It is estimated that
he had knocked on more than 1,000 doors before he got his first order. How many of us quit after 3 tries, 10 tries, 100 tries, and then we say we tried as hard as we could? Okay. Let us discuss in detail. Yes, Colonel Sanders, he is a founder of KFC Chicken. As we have discussed earlier, that he is the founder of KFC chain restaurants. Okay. He at the age of 65 worked hard. He at the age of 65 worked hard and succeeded in selling food items. Okay. He had knocked on more than 1,000 doors before he got his first order. Okay. So he at the age of 65 with a beat up car. What is the meaning of a beat up car? It is very old and damaged. And he had how much amount in his hand? $100. That is also from the, he got the check from the Social Security. What does the Social Security mean? In the United States, it means that a system in which people pay money regularly to the government when they are working, okay, and receive payments from the government when they are unable to work, especially when they are sick or too old to work. It is like a pension. It is like a pension. Okay. So when they work, they pay amount to the government, and when they are unable to work, the government will pay that amount. Okay. This is called as Social Security. So at the age of 65, he realized that he had to do something, and he remembered his mother's recipe. What's the meaning of recipe here? It is a set of instructions that tells you to something and the ingredients, that is about the items of the food you need to cook. Okay. So he remembered his mother's recipe, and he know how to cook, and he also know all the ingredients, what are all necessary for cooking that fried chicken. Okay. So he had knocked more than 1,000 doors before he got his first order. Okay. How many of us are going to quit? We may try one time or two times or three times or 10 times and or 100 tries. And then we say at last, what do we say? That we tried as hard as we could. But here, in his case, he at the age of 65, actually it was the time for him to take the rest, right? It was the time for him to retire. But he did not take any kind of rest, and he wanted to prove something. Okay, what is that quality that man showed here? It is a perseverance. The quality that he showed here is a perseverance. It is act of trying to achieve something even there are difficulties. Just like Nick Hughes in Attitude is Altitude, here Colonel Sanders also showed the quality of perseverance. Let us go through one more example about the life history of Walt Disney. Okay. Let us go to the lesson. As a young cartoonist, Walt Disney faced many rejections from newspaper editors who said he had no talent. One day, a minister at a church hired him to draw some cartoons. Disney was working out of a small mouse infested shed near the church. After seeing a small mouse, he was inspired. That was the start of Mickey Mouse. Successful people don't do great things. They only do small things in a great way. Okay, let us discuss in detail. We all know the cartoon character, Walt Disney, right? At the beginning, who was the creator of Mickey Mouse was also rejected by saying that he has no talent. Okay, he was also rejected by saying that he has no talent. And you know, his career began with a drawing of a mouse. One day, what happened? A minister at a church. Minister means a priest at a church hired him. Hired means he gave an employment for him to draw some cartoons. Okay, so from there, he became the world famous person. So he is called as he is good example to say that successful people don't do great things, they only do small things in a great way. His life has turned when he got job near the church. The church minister asked him to draw some cartoons. So he saw a mouse infested near the church and he got inspired and he drew the picture of the mouse, and from then his life has changed. So he is the best example to say that successful people don't do great things, they only do small things in a great way. Okay, let us discuss one more example about Thomas Alva Edison. Let us discuss about the life history of one more person. Let us go to the lesson here. One day, a partially deaf 4-year-old kid came home with a note in his pocket from his teacher. "Your Tommy is too stupid to learn. Get them out of the school." His mother read the note and answered, "My Tommy is not stupid to learn. I will teach him myself." And that Tommy grew up to be the great Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison had only 3 months of formal schooling and he was partially deaf. Okay, we all know Thomas Edison, who was partially deaf. He failed nearly 10,000 times while he was working on the light bulb. Okay, he didn't give up and he got success finally. And this man had a formal schooling only for 3 months. So his teacher put a note in his pocket and said that your Tommy is too stupid to learn. As he was partially deaf, teacher felt that he could not learn the things in the school. So his mother did not give up and she herself taught his son. Okay, and this Tommy grew up to be the great Thomas Edison. He was a man with a great attitude. Okay, so though he had schooling only for 3 months, he became a great successful person in his life, and later he invented a light bulb. Okay, next example, it is about Henry Ford. Henry Ford forget to put the reverse gear in the first car he made. Yes, who is this Henry Ford? Henry Ford, we all know about the car company Ford, right? A car company Ford. Henry Ford, what did he do? He forgot to put the reverse gear when he made his first car. What is the meaning of gear? What is the meaning of gear? Or gear, it is a machinery in a vehicle such as car or truck or a bicycle that we use to go comfortably at different speed. So what did he do when he made his first car? He forgot to put the reverse gear. So all these people have having success in their lives only after their failures, right? They weren't lucky. Only thing is, their determination was firm and they became successful in their lives. Do you consider these people failures? They succeeded in spite of problems, not in the absence of them. But to the outside world, it appears as though they just got lucky. Yes, after studying the life history of these people like Abraham Lincoln, Lady Forrest, Colonel Sanders, do we think they all are failures? No, right? So they all succeeded in spite of the problems. Though they have problems, they became successful in their lives, but not in the absence of them. Here, them means failures. But to the outside world, it appears as though they just got lucky. We feel that they are very lucky people, but it is not correct, right? Okay. All success stories are stories of great failures. The only difference is that every time they failed, they did not give up. They bounced back. What does it mean? Bounced back means they recovered and they started newly. This is called failing forward rather than backward. It means that accepting the failures and moving forward. So you learn and move forward. You have to learn from your failures and you have to move forward. Learn from your failures and keep moving. We should not give up. We should bounce back. Again, we have to start newly so that we can be successful in our lives. Okay. So in 1914, Thomas Edison, at age 67, lost his factory, which was worth a few million dollars on fire. It had very little insurance. No longer a young man, Edison watched his lifetime effort go up in smoke and said, "There is a great value in disaster. All our mistakes are burnt up. Thank God, we can start anew." In spite of the disaster, 3 weeks later, he invented the phonograph. What an attitude! So in the year 1914, Thomas Edison, at the age of 67 means it was almost a time to retire, right? Retirement age. All his lifetime effort, what happened? But a few million dollars met with a fire accident. Okay, and this, it had a very little insurance. Little means not much insurance, but he was not disappointed. Here Thomas Edison was not disappointed and he started newly. Okay, and he invented a machine called phonograph, a machine which is it is a record player. Okay, so here we can know the attitude of this person. He is really very positive. It shows that he is very positive. He did not give up and he felt that and he was not disappointed, and he also felt that all our mistakes are burnt up, and he thanked God. He did not criticize the God for doing this. See, and he thanked God, and later, within few weeks, he invented a machine called phonograph, which is a record player. Okay, children. So below are few more examples of the failures of successful people. Let us go through. Thomas Edison. Till now we have discussed about Thomas Edison. This man had only formal schooling for 3 months. His teacher asked him to take him away from the school. His mother taught him later, right? And at the age of 67, he lost his factory. Okay? And even though he did not give up, later he invented phonograph. Okay? So he is really very positive in his life. You know, Thomas Edison, he failed approximately nearly how many times? 10,000 times while he was working on the light bulb. Okay? And Henry Ford was broke at the age of 40. Broke means he had no money at the age of 40. And Lee Iacocca was fired by Henry Ford too at the age of 54. Lee Iacocca, he was dismissed by Henry Ford at the age of 54. And young Beethoven, he was told that he had no talent for music, but he gave some of the best music to the world. So these are few more examples about the people who failed in their lives, but later they achieved success. Okay, so setbacks are inevitable. Setbacks means difficulties or problems or obstacles are inevitable. Inevitable means which we cannot avoid. They are unstoppable in life. A setback can act as a driving force. Driving force and teaches humility. So a setback means a problem should act as a driving force and it should teach us how to be humble. In grief, you will find courage and faith to overcome the setback. In grief means sorrow. In grief, you will find courage and faith to overcome the setback. We have to find courage and faith to overcome the setback. We need to learn to become victors. Okay? Victors means we should become winners, not victims. Victim means one who suffer. Fear and doubt short circuit the mind. So we must get rid of fear and doubt. We need to try to become victors and not the victims. Ask yourself after every setback. So you have to question yourself. You have to question yourself after every failure that what did I learn from this experience? Only then you will be able to turn a stumbling block into a stepping stone. What is the meaning of stumbling block? Here stumbling blocks means they are the failures. Okay? A situation that causes difficulties in our lives. So whenever you ask yourself, whenever you learn yourself after every setback, and that is going to become a stepping stone. Stepping stone means success in your lives. Okay, children? So the motivation to succeed comes from burning desire. Burning desire means burning desire is the only key to the success. Burning desire means it should be your wish should be very strong. Napoleon Hill wrote, whatever the mind of a man can conceive and believe, the man can achieve. So, who is Napoleon Hill? He is a famous author. He is a famous author, wrote many books. The famous one is Think and Grow Rich. Among his books, the famous book is Think and Grow Rich. So, anyone who want a personal success in their lives should read this book. What is that book? Think and Grow Rich. So, what did he say? He said that whatever the mind of a man can conceive. Conceive means a plan or an idea. If you have a plan or an idea in your mind and if you believe in it, definitely you are going to achieve. Okay? If your desire is weak, your result will be weak. And if you are strong, your results will be very strong. Okay? One day, a young man asked Socrates the secret to success. So, Socrates, who is Socrates? He is a Greek philosopher. He is a Greek philosopher. And one day, a young man came to him and he asked the secret to the success. Okay? So, Socrates suggested that burning desire is the only secret to one's success. Okay? So, he asked the young man to meet him next morning. He asked the young man to meet him next morning and both of them met. Socrates asked the young man to walk with him towards the river. So, they both of them were walking into the river and when the water got up to their neck, the water level reached up to the neck. So, Socrates took the young man by surprise and dunked him into the water. Dunked him means he pushed into the water and the boy struggled to get out, but Socrates was very strong and kept him there. So this boy wanted to get out of the water, but even harder, with great force, Socrates dunked him into the water. And that boy started turning blue. Blue means he was about to dying. Okay, Socrates pulled his head out of the water, and the first thing the young man did was to gasp and take a deep breath of air. So when this man came out of the water, he took a deep breath, that is gasp. Gasp means taking excess amount of air. This is gasping. Okay, so Socrates asked, what do you want the most when you were there? So Socrates asked a question. So when you were inside the water, what do you want? The boy replied, air. Socrates said, that is the secret to success. When you want success as badly as you wanted the air, then you will get it. There is no other secret. Okay, children. So here, the young man asked the Socrates a secret to success. So one day he asked the young man to come to the river next day, and Socrates suggested him that burning desire is the only secret to one success. Okay, and if we don't have a desire, we cannot achieve anything. A burning desire is a starting point of all accomplishments. Okay, a weak desire can't produce great results. The motivation to get the success comes from the burning desire to achieve a purpose. Okay, so burning desire is the starting point of all accomplishments. Accomplishments means fulfillments, just like a small fire. Small fire means small wish cannot give much heat. A weak desire cannot produce great results. Here, weak desire means our wish is not that strong, and if we are weak, we cannot produce great results. The motivation is to get success comes from the burning desire to achieve a purpose. Here, purpose means a will or a determination. If you think you are beaten, you are. If you think you dare not, you don't. If you like to win but think you can't, it's almost a cinch you won't. If you think you will lose, you are lost. For out in the world we find, success begins with a fellow's will. It's all in the state of mind. Okay. So if you think you are beaten, what is the meaning of beaten? If you think you are defeated, you are. It is all about the mindset of your own. Okay. If you think you are beaten, you are. That means if you think you are defeated, you are. And if you think you are dare not means you are not daring enough, you don't. And if you like to win but you think you can't, everyone wants to win in their life, everyone wants to be successful in their lives, but if you think that you can't, it's almost a cinch you won't. Cinch means a thing that is certain to happen. If you think you can't, it is not going to happen. Okay, if you think you will lose, you are lost. For out in the world we find, success begins with a fellow's will. It's all in the state of mind. It is completely depends upon the person's will. Okay, if you think you can, you are going to be successful. It depends upon your state of mind. Okay, next let us see here. If you think you are outclassed, what is the meaning of outclassed? If you think others are better than you, you are. Okay, if you have got to think high to rise, you have got to be sure of yourself before you can even win a prize. Okay, if you got to think high to rise, if you want to become successful in your lives, only thing is you should have a positive in your thoughts, then you can win a prize. Life's battles don't always go, okay, to the stronger and faster man, but sooner or later, the man who wins is the man who thinks he can. See here, children, last four lines. Life's battles don't always go. So one needs to be positive in one's thoughts. One needs to think high to get success. The person who thinks can easily win in the end. Victory is not always on the side of the stronger
or faster man. Okay, children. Hope you all understood this lesson. If you have any doubts, you can discuss me.